Monkeys. Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. We are doing more party games. Who would have guessed? There's like 85 more, even though there's 50 in the game. Anyway, as you can see by the jigsaw puzzle controls, it's pretty simple game. Zoom out with a D-pad. Oh my god, a 48-piece puzzle. This is gonna take me a while. Well, at least to do that one. And, okay, memorize the picture. Oh yeah, get your game face on. This is extreme jigsaw puzzling right here. Alright, just get these edge pieces set up like so. I bet you this is going to be incredibly boring to watch. You rotate the pieces by rotating your hand, if you didn't get that. And that's going to be a necessity to get through these. Just saying. I think this one actually goes here. Yes, it does. I have done jigsaw puzzles on my as another hobby in a spare time. I haven't done one ages though. Always start with the edges. I think it's just to get the pieces out of the way and get a sense of the picture and whatnot. Get out of my way. I wanted to grab that one because I believe that goes here. Yes, it does. Oh my, should I be speeding this up or something? This might be a bad editing decision on my part. I'm unsure actually where. Oh, I've got these two mixed up, don't I? I am a pro. Yeah, there we go. And now I have it. Voila! Apparently my best record was just under a minute. I highly doubt that's the default time because, it's the default times I would assume is like, an even number or something like that. Anyway, this was Jay playing this. Yeah, that's what I thought. And next puzzle! When it can, load. There we go. I still don't understand why we need to center the Wii remote. That is what the sensor bar is supposed to do. Because, it can tell the relative position of the Wii remote based on how far away it notices the, how spaced apart the dots are on that infrared thing. By the way, in case you don't realize, this is a moving picture now, which makes things infinitely harder. This reminds me so much of the moving picture puzzles in Banjo-Kazooie. If you ever play that game, it's more like an Easter egg secret above Banjo's fireplace. If you look up at the thing, you'll be able to play puzzles based on how far you got into the game. Perhaps I have said too much about that secret, but it is worth checking out if you have the game. Just go into first-person mode. Go stand in front of his fireplace and look up at the picture of, I believe it's bottles above his fireplace. I could be wrong. And yeah, you'll be able to play a moving picture puzzle similar to this. This would be a ridiculously awesome jigsaw puzzle idea, if not for the fact that it would be incredibly expensive to manufacture. I was looking at the wrong piece here. Imagine having these little tiny TV screens just like this attached to all these pieces and then trying to get them within a budget package. I just don't see it happening anytime soon. I have done puzzles where you have like those pictures that have that textured material that makes the picture look like it's moving depending on the angle that you look at it. I forgot the name of that, whatever it is, whatever texture that thing is, but you probably know what I mean, what I'm talking about here, and that makes the puzzle exceptionally difficult, and I tend to do difficult jigsaw puzzles like that whenever I do jigsaw puzzles for the sake of challenge, basically. I never shy from a challenge. And if you didn't realize that, from my videos and whatnot and the games that I've played in the past, Trauma Center is, I am low on battery, must switch Wii remote, don't move!
Don't move, please, don't leave. I got another one. Yes, okay.
We are safe. We are good. I need to put that one on the charger after this part. I think that one goes there. Yep. Please, snap into place. There we go. And this one turned twice, I think. Yep. Boop. Gone. I said boop. Woo! And one more puzzle to do. Maybe this won't take me as long as I thought it would. Unless the last one is going to be ridiculously difficult or something like that. And wow, I get first place. That is... No, that's impossible. No. Oh, it appears I only played that one once before. Well, that explains it. My record was pretty atrocious because I got through that pretty quickly. Maybe I just didn't have the vision that I did now or something like that. I don't know. Yeah, center. Dang ladybug. Just don't get that. Monkey Carnival. What do we have here? Is this... Is it a moving picture or not? Ready? Oh, it is. It's just that the, picture isn't, it's like flashing rather than moving. I don't really know if that's gonna make much of a difference, because, you know, the pieces that are gonna match are gonna be, you know, synced up, so to speak. I should probably be getting ye ol' edge pieces together here, because this is a lot larger puzzle. Not that one. This one too, please. And this one. That's not one. Got to confuse with the background. The pieces are also a lot smaller. I would definitely prefer doing jigsaw puzzles in real life over in a game. Just saying. I think that should be obvious, even though, you know, you can't have fantasy puzzles like this in a real-life puzzle for obvious reasons. I got this one. Oh, the best record is 15 minutes. Am I going to finish this puzzle by the end of this part? I really hate to have a part, you know, just dedicated to jigsaw puzzles. That would be... Oh my...
I'm glad I sped that one up. I could not commentate for that long on a jigsaw puzzle. I don't normally approve of doing the whole speed up slash put music over things, because, you know, people watch other people's videos for the commentary, or at least, you know, when people do commentary on their videos and they subscribe to them for that. But come on now, that was preposterous. I'm not gonna have a part of me just solving a jigsaw puzzle. It says 20 minutes on the camera right now. Well, getting to it, 1950. But let's just do some jump rope now. And that puzzle actually had some issues. If there was any... Whoops. I accidentally twitched. If there was any pieces on top of other pieces, you wouldn't be able to grab the pieces under it. Like, you wouldn't be able to slide it under them or something like that, which doesn't really make much sense. Why can't you grab pieces if they're partially under other pieces? That is preposterous. Another reason why I would prefer doing a jigsaw puzzle in real life than one in a video game or computer game or whatever. Well, they're both about the same. Anyway, needless to say, this is jump rope. Just flick the Wii Remote upwards when you want your monkey friend to jump, and I accidentally twitched again. I think you get the idea of jump rope. I don't really want to do this a third time. It's another one of those linear games that won't really interest you all that much, or at least I don't think it will. Anyway, keep you up. This is actually... I don't know if this is a game based on internet flash games that do this, or like flash games are based on other games. I don't know. But this Keepy Up game here reminds me of so much of like those Keepy Up flash games on like Newgrounds or something like that. And the objective is to keep the monkeys bounced on the bat for as long as possible, obviously. And that's pretty difficult to do on this bat, as you can see here. So wish me luck with that, I suppose. I'm only playing this once, obviously. I don't intend on playing games more than I need to show how they're going, because of the fact that, I mean, to show how they play, because as I said before, if I play the games as many times as I need to, you know, get the hang of them, I will never, ever get done. So once or twice is good enough, excuse me. And I see the score multiplier up there gives you more points depending on how many, maybe not. I thought maybe the more you hit it in a row, oh, it does give you bonus points depending on if you get like a combo of sorts going. Oh, okay. That's all I'm doing there. Be happy. That got me third place, seriously? Well, Jay is not going to complain. Let's do two more games, I think. Monkey bowling, or this one might actually take me a while, so I think it'll just be that I'll be doing this one and that'll be about it, I think. Alright, you just aim by, you know, moving the Wii Remote left and right, then when you're ready to shoot, you press the A button, and then you swing the Wii Remote forward to throw your monkey. Now, the angle that your ball has spin depends on how your wrist is twisted. This is very, very hard to get it to go straight. I always seem to have a right-to-left curve, so I always do it like here and then throw it, and somehow I ended up getting a left-to-right curve. What? That... Huh? My wrist was twisted counterclockwise when I threw that. What? That is not how bowling works. I swear I'm twisting my wrist counterclockwise. I wish I could put the camera on me, you know, in the middle of this to show exactly what I'm doing. See, I got it. I got what I wanted to do that time, but I didn't have the power to hit the center pin off on the side like I wanted to. Your wrist speed is also, well, I should say your arm speed is also a factor in how, you know, the spin affects the ball. And why did it go that way again?
You tell me, why did that go that way? I swear I am twisting my wrist to go like that. That's how it's supposed to go. And it should cross over and hit the one pin. The best way to get strikes in bowling, if you didn't know this, is to have it hit, have your ball hit the one and two or one and three pins at the front at about the exact same time, and then the rest of the pins will follow suit. And you have to hit it at a slight angle. And I wonder if this is me or if it's the control. I really can't tell. It's been a while since I played this version of Monkey Bowling. I've always preferred the second Monkey Bowling over the first, or this one, which is kind of like why I've played the second one, or yeah, you get the idea. Wow, 4 frames and I've got 21 points. This is professional gaming at its finest. And I didn't have enough power to keep him going. Come on, Gong Gong, we can do this. Why? It seems like I'm... How am I overspinning him now? I'm pretty sure I'm, you know, flicking the Wii Remote harder than I was before, and... Wow, he's... and you know, you see I'm playing way off on the right side. It's probably a feel thing, and it's just that I'm bad at it, but... Wow, I'm getting nothing but the 7 pin at this point. Okay, I'm gonna try and do this straight this time. And somehow I managed to still... Is it possible to throw the ball straight? I'm kind of unsure. I'm going to attempt to just do a little forward flick. I guess so. But it's gotta be very gentle, apparently. Alright, I'm just gonna try for it straight this time. Little gentle flick, and somehow I got some spin. That's a better result, I suppose. But really, in bowling, you should attempt to spin the ball into the front two pins, as I said before. I didn't mean to get spin that way. I'm only playing one game of this, that's for sure. And I got no spin on that one. I am astonished. I am never going to get a strike, though. Is it possible to get a strike? I am slightly unsure at this point. Wow, how did I get that much spin from just a flick? Yeah, I honestly can't tell if this is me or if it's the game's controls that's giving me such haphazard spins and rolls. Because right now I'm doing these tiny flicks with my wrists pointed straight upwards and And see, I'm getting spin in both directions and I don't know. Oh well, that's the 10th frame and I didn't even get the extra frame. That's fine. I'm happy with my 42. I didn't even get a single spare. Well, I'm gonna leave it at that. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part.